The Off-White Niek Blazer. This is a sneaker that is debatably one of the best shoes from the 10 collection that Nike did with Virgil Abloh. This is a shoe that's reselling for over $1,000 on the resale market, and it's a shoe I continue to beat up because I paid retail for it, and so I don't feel as bad beating these up. But there's a shoe that you can actually just go out and buy right now for the most part that is like one-fifth or one-tenth the price of this particular shoe, and it really gives off a very similar aesthetic. So that's gonna be one of the shoes I show you guys in today's unboxing and haul, sneaker haul video. I have another pair of shoes to also show you and two sneakers I was sent over. So let's get over to the gifted pickups, we could say. Vans Canada and ASICS sent over some heat, so let's get to it. So literally 5 minutes ago, the FedEx man just dropped off a Vans package. It was in a big brown box. I've already unboxed it, but this is the shoe box for it right here. We've got the all over Vans print. Thank you, Vans Canada, for the love. This is the Comfy Cush Authentic Vans. Now, if you guys know, the Vans Authentic, it's typically not the most comfortable sneaker in the world out there. Let's be honest, it's not meant for like all day wear. Your feet are gonna be sore by the end of the day. But big but, Vans has now come out with a comfier version of the Authentic Vans, and I wanna show them to you guys. Got some wrapping paper, let's get that out of the way. Here we go. Yo, I love the color on these. These are actually gonna go really well with some clothing pickups I also wanna show you guys at some point in today's haul. But this is the brand new Vans Comfy Cush Authentic sneaker. This has that beautiful, famous checkerboard print. You guys know I absolutely love. And this is really light, and it has the Comfy Cush technology, which Vans says is going to be quite comfortable. So there's the insole right here. I tried taking it out. I'm struggling to take it out, but there's the Vans insole, Comfy Cush technology. Let me show you guys a little 360 of the Vans Comfy Cush Authentic while I read you guys a little letter that Vans sent over. Welcome to Cloud 9. Vans classics have been reimagined with a first-class upgrade, Comfy Cush. A unique foam and rubber construction is the perfect combination of comfort and grip, while a newly constructed upper focuses on the tongue stabilization and added arch support. Signed, the Vans Canada and Bicom's team. So thank you, Vans Canada and Bicom teams. Appreciate you guys. See, clothing pickups for today's video are gonna go perfectly with the shoes I just showed you, and they come in from my friend's brand, Kyopo. Kyopo represents like the second generation of immigrants like coming over to Canada, kicking ass, doing really well, being successful. I'm probably butchering the brand's vision really poorly, but if you guys want more info on Sam's brand, Kyopo, I'll leave a link down below his website, and it really celebrates a lot of like Korean pride, and his clothing brand also celebrates Filipino pride as well. The first two pickups from his brand is, let's show you guys the first one right here. This blue oversized sweater, really soft. This thing is crazy soft, gonna be nice and cozy for those nights in, or if I want to go out and about and have like a really cool bold blue outfit, I can do that. We have the Kyopo tag right there as well. Embroidery action going down the middle. I'm not entirely sure what it stands for, what it translates to. And then on the back, there's nothing. So just a very simple blue oversized sweater. Oh, I totally missed the detail. It says never separated, forever connected on the sleeve right there in the white embroidery. These match perfectly. Ah, yes. Next up, let's get to the blue hoodie, which will also go with it. And this is from his Manila X Toronto line. Now, as you guys know, I'm a proud Filipino. I've been to the Philippines a couple of times now over the last year. And this is the blue hoodie from the line. These use Champion hoodies as their base. And as you guys know, Champion hoodies are super popular right now. One of the most popular hoodies you can buy. Very soft, I have to say. And it has a like Filipino Canadian flag. I'm Filipino Canadian, so this is like, it resonates with me a lot. And on the back is probably one of my favorite things about this sweater, because it's loud and it screams you have Filipino pride. Manila X Toronto. Toronto. So if you guys liked the blue Manila X Toronto hoodie, then you'll probably also like the red hoodie as well. So again, exact same deal as before. We have the Filipino Canadian flag right here, that cool embroidery on the side. Then we got the Manila X Toronto on the back, all white with that red. And just a heads up for you guys who are interested in the Kyopo brand, I'll leave his website linked down below. And if you use code SNEAKERTALK, I think you'll get like 20% off, something like that. So use code SNEAKERTALK. I don't make any money or anything like that. It's just a friendly discount code for you guys. Now let's get to the last streetwear pickup, which honestly would be my favorite if it weren't for the Manila Toronto collection that he did. This bold, happy yellow hoodie. It is so soft and it's an all yellow hoodie. It has black drawstrings running down the middle right here. We got the Kyopo branding on the inside, which I want to show you guys as well. There's Kyopo. I got a size large, and then there's some extra Kyopo branding on the inside. Really nice detail there. On the sides of the sleeves, on the inner sides, like the inner panel of the sleeve, you get this yellow and black Kyopo, 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 Kyopo branding all on the side of the sleeve right there on the inside part. The back is my favorite part. It says Kyopo, never separated, forever connected. And then it has a huge, like, the missions of the brand right here. It says, being Kyopo is not just a way to identify us, it is in our blood, it is who we are and what we are proud to be, not belonging anywhere and belonging everywhere at the same time. Never forget your past and to embrace in the present. So there's like a whole big paragraph thing you guys can read on the back of the sweater, and I'm sure you can read it on the website as well for Kyopo, but that is the back of the sweater. Really clean overall. I mess with this a lot. Really cozy. You guys will catch me in this a lot. If you guys see me in a yellow hoodie, it's most likely going to be this hoodie, because I gave my girlfriend my yellow Puma XO hoodie, so I have not seen that in a long time. Thank you again, Sam from Kyopo. Check out Kyopo, link down below. Use code SNEAKERTALK on its website for a discount. So the next sneaker pickup comes in from the homies over at A6 Canada, and they sent over a very, very expensive collaboration that's like $320 Canadian. Whew. Damn. Thank you, A6. These are the A6, and how do you pronounce his name properly? Kiko Kostanov? Kostanov? Kiko Kostanov. And Kiko Kostanov is actually a Bulgarian designer, which is pretty cool. You don't really see too many Bulgarian designers on the scene as far as all these streetwear and stuff goes. So this is a collab with A6 and Kiko. This isn't the first time I think A6 and Kiko have collabed. I'm pretty sure they've done so in the past, but they did three colorways on this particular shoe. This is the black blue, like black, dark blue, lavender colorway. We'll get to it in a second, but they did include a little note, and they did send this to me like 3 weeks ago. So sorry, A6, it's taken forever for me to get to this package. But the note here reads, Christian wanted you to be one of the first to rock the new A6 and Kiko Kostadinov Gel Diva shoes. Gel Diva shoes? Gel Diva? Look at that. I love the mixture. This is a color scheme you're not used to at all. We got the lavender hits. We got the A6 branding in the background. It's not something I'm used to seeing from A6, so definitely a very unique spin on an A6 model. The two other colorways are really dope, but I think my favorite from this collection was the yellow one they did. The yellow pops really well, and I think it would have gone perfectly with the Kyopo hoodie I just showed you guys. I think one of the few retailers that are selling these in Toronto and in Canada is Haven. So check out Haven's website, and I'll leave these linked down below to Haven's website if you guys want to check them out. With that said, let's get to the two sneaker pickups I actually purchased myself. We got the Nike Air Skylon 2. Now, the Air Skylon or Skylon 2, I think is a sneaker that they recently did a collaboration with Fear of God. And I bought these from Livestock website for half price. Retail price was $140 Canadian, and I paid 70, which is like $45 US for these right here, the Nike Skylon 2. Really, really dope summer shoe, I gotta say. I love this way the gradient is on the shoe. It's like a pink to purple. That is my first Nike sneaker pickup for today's video. I'll have a review of this sneaker up, I think, on my second channel, Sneaker Talk 365. So subscribe over there for the review of these bad boys. Hopefully they're good. I mean, they weren't too expensive. I got them for half price, $45 US. So very happy with this pickup. But this is not the shoe that I think might be better than the Off White Niek Blazer.
Where's my Off White Nike Blazer?
The shoe that I think might be better than the Off White Blazer is another Nike Blazer. That's why I'm gonna be comparing the two. But this is the original box, or the box for the shoes. This is like an OG Nike looking box. That old orange color. We have the Nike Blazer Mid 77 Vintage. Retail price, $135 Canadian. These were actually released in a pack with a couple of other colorways. But first up, let me show you guys the colorway I ended up buying. I have already started to wear them already. I wore them once. And this is the blue colorway right here. They also did release a red colorway and a green colorway, which both look really clean and really good in my opinion. I wanted to get the green colorway just because I don't have too many green sneakers in my collection, but my size for those shoes did sell out pretty fast. They were gone pretty much as soon as I wanted to buy them. And then they had the red colorway, and I was like, do I really need another white and red sneaker? I have enough of them. I love my Chicago ones, so let's switch it up and get the blue. Now, the main difference between these ones and the other Blazers is that on this version, they actually have like this hit of suede on the side right here. It's different. You can call it like a mud guard, if you will. We got a little bit on the toe box too, which is obviously going to be a little bit of a dirt magnet. So if you're trying to keep these clean, good luck. We got this nice blue on the side with a swoosh. We got the Nike branding on the back stitched in. And of course, we got the OG Nike branding right here for the tongue. We got the exposed foam tongue everyone knows and loves for the Blazers. Wearing this shoe, I was like getting the same kind of vibes I get when I wear this off-white shoe. Maybe because it's the same model, because it's the Blazer. But honestly, guys, if you are a huge fan of the Nike Off-White Blazer, I think you should give these vintage 99 or vintage 77, yeah, vintage 77 Blazer mids a try. If you have them on feet, they really feel exactly the same. Like, the comfort is exactly the same. And if you really wanted to, you could possibly do some like DIY deconstruction to this shoe and make it look a little bit more like this. But overall, very clean sneaker. This will go with a lot of different outfits. This is good for like streetwear outfits, but at the same time, it's also good for like preppier outfits or a date night kind of outfit. And if you took an L on these in your country or are just having a really hard time and you're getting a little bit impatient trying to buy these for retail, you can try and find these on apps like StockX and GOAT. They are reselling for slightly over retail. If you guys made it to the end of the video, this is the comment question of the day. Of course, smash that thumbs up button down below if you guys want to support the channel. Subscribe for more videos, but most importantly, I want to hear your opinions, your thoughts in the comment section down below. So the question of the day is, do you only like off-white Blazers, or do you like these Blazers too? Because I know a lot of people only like the Blazers when it comes to the off-white version, but I mean, these are great in my opinion. And yeah, what's your favorite color? Do you like the blue, the green, or the red? I like the green the most, but blue was my second choice, and that's what was available. Anyways, I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace out.